Chapter 1084, Resource Struggle. Everything that occurred within the simulation Mystic Realm, all of the fighting and chaos, fell into Mo River Bliss's eyes, when she saw Lin Ming form a force field space around him that was able to shield against all attacks and even twist apart the iron bodies of the puppets. She was startled. What sort of force field is that, that could be so powerful? Mo River Bliss was naturally referring to Lin Ming's Grand Mist Space. There were an infinite number of force fields and a martial artist could even form their own unique force field, so not recognizing this one was normal. What Mo River Bliss was surprised at was that the quality of Lin Ming's force field was extremely high. Mo Eversnow hesitated for a moment and ultimately told everything that happened to Lin Ming in the Road of Ember to Mo River Bliss. Towards Mo River Bliss that had watched over and taken care of her growing up, Mo Eversnow had complete trust. What did you say? Empyrean Primordius? Grand Mist Space. What Lin Ming used just now was the Primordius martial intent. Mo River Bliss was alarmed. If Mo Eversnow didn't tell her this, she would never have recognized it. Empyrean Primordius had disappeared 100,000 years ago. And at that time Mo River Bliss wasn't even famous. Even before Empyrean Primordius was missing, he had gone into a semi-reclusive state. The time when he shook the Divine Realm and conquered its heroes had been millions or even tens of millions of years ago. At that time, Mo River Bliss hadn't even been born. Thinking about it even further, even the old Holy Lord of the Verdant Feather Holy Lands hadn't been born yet back then. Mo River Bliss only ever heard stories and tales about a legendary figure like Empyrean Primordius. These stories only mentioned the Grand Mist Space. As for what the Grand Mist Space was, she had no idea. If Mo Eversnow didn't tell her, she would never have realized this. Mo Eversnow said, what Lin Ming comprehended is not a complete Primordius martial intent, but only a part of it. The Heavenly Demon martial intent. Only a part? Mo River Bliss's eyelids trembled. The legends say that the complete Primordius martial intent is divided into three parts. They're the Heavenly Demon martial intent, Heavenly Mortal martial intent, and Heavenly God martial intent. Demon, Mortal, God. When all three are combined, that is the complete Primordius martial intent. This martial intent is considered an extremely high-ranked ability even amongst all the different transcendent divine mites. Mo River Bliss stood up, revealing a thoughtful expression. She whispered, unbelievable, to think that Lin Ming obtained the inheritance of Empyrean Primordius is simply unbelievable. Mo River Bliss's expression was complex. She was incomparably clear as to what an Empyrean was. That was an existence that truly stood at the very peak of the divine realm. Once one reached the boundary of an Empyrean, they no longer bothered with the general affairs of the divine realm. In their opinion, even if two great worlds of the divine realm were to wage war against each other, that would simply be nothing but a little squabble. What they wholeheartedly searched for was the great Tao, and to find the clues to eternal, everlasting life, to the martial artists of the divine realm. They were the true divine gods that could not be touched. If it weren't for Mo Eversnow telling her, Mo River Bliss would never have known about the fight between Empyreans 100,000 ago. It was even more impossible to think that Empyreans would battle in some place like the lower realms and not the divine realm. Between Empyreans, just why would they fight? And a life or death war at that? It was hard to imagine what existed in this universe that was worth them desperately risking their lives for. Was it a treasure on the level of a magic cube? The old Holy Lord of the Verdant Feather Holy Lands was able to keep the magic cube because the existence of the magic cube was a secret to begin with. Very few people knew about it. Even the allies of the Yao-Ming-Sai only knew the name of the magic cube when they helped assault the Verdant Feather Holy Lands. As for what it was, they weren't sure. Everything that Mo River Bliss knew about the magic cube and how valuable it was had all been speculated by the old Holy Lord. But Mo River Bliss was not able to fully confirm any of this. She had no choice but to wonder. Could even something like the magic cube cause Empyrean level masters to fight in a life or death war? Of course, a war between Empyreans was not something that Mo River Bliss could imagine or even ask about. Perhaps only Empyrean Primordius and Empyrean Thunder Punishment, who had both participated in that war 100,000 years ago, would know these secrets. However, if Lin Ming could obtain Empyrean Primordius' inheritance, in comparison, the Verdant Feather Holy Land's inheritances were actually somewhat pale and weak. After thinking of this, Mo River Bliss's impression towards Lin Ming underwent a great change. Auntie, do you still plan on testing Lin Ming? Mo Eversnow asked. She had thought for some time before revealing this matter to Mo River Bliss. It wasn't that she didn't believe Mo River Bliss was untrustworthy, but rather that this matter was far too significant and the less people that were aware of it the better. In the end, she told Mo River Bliss because she wanted her aunt to trust Lin Ming more. Mo River Bliss was lost in thought for some time. She said, although you said that Lin Ming stumbled into Empyrean Primordius' inheritance and obtained it in a mystic realm, for such a character like Empyrean Primordius, even if he perished, his inheritance is still not something the average person could ever hope of laying their hands on. It could be said that Lin Ming is the designated descendant of Empyrean Primordius. For him to obtain this inheritance, that might even be faintly part of the calculations that Empyrean Primordius made so long ago. Since Lin Ming is the descendant chosen by Empyrean Primordius, I truly do not have the qualifications to test him. Compared to an Empyrean, even our Verdant Feather Holy Lands is not worth mentioning. Little Snow, don't blame Auntie for being so stingy. The issue is that the Ten Severing Tao Fruit Drew is equally significant to Carefree Island, so I had to carefully consider it. Moreover, Carefree Island is also experiencing extremely difficult troubles. The disciples of Carefree Island are being suppressed in the Divergent Mystic Realm by the joint forces of Splendor Soul Mountain and the Occult Bone Clan. Now, the lifeline of our resources is in an increasingly tenuous position. If Carefree Island loses the Ten Severing Tao Fruit and Lin Ming cannot grow within the next 1,000 years, Carefree Island will truly be in danger, let alone becoming a holy land. Even maintaining our current status will be dangerous. If I make any mistakes, The chess piece your grandfather placed down with so much effort will lose all of its value. Occult Bone Clan? Splinter Soul Mountain? Mo Eversnow asked, surprised. Who are they? They are Carefree Island's rivals and enemies. The sea area that our Carefree Island is located in is named the Red Desolate Sea. This name originates from the diverse mystic realm hidden beneath the seabed, the entrance to the Red Desolate Mystic Realm. As for Carefree Island, the Occult Bone Clan, and Splinter Soul Mountain, they are the three great influences that exist in the Red Desolate Sea. In the Red Desolate Mystic Realm, there is all sorts of raw medicinal herbs, ores, and other types of resources. Although these resources aren't considered too precious, there's an extremely large quantity of them. So this divergent mystic realm is the greatest source of resources for our three sects. Tens of thousands of years ago, the three sects were small and weak. In order to maintain control over the Red Desolate Sea and the Red Desolate Mystic Realm, the three sects joined together to combat outside enemies. At that time, even though the relations between the sects were volatile, they were still relatively harmonious. But as the years progressed and the three sects developed, growing larger and larger, there inevitably appeared the ambition to rule over the entire Red Desolate Sea. If one sect could rule over the entire Red Desolate Sea and also absorb the other two sects, in another 10,000 years of growth, it is absolutely possible to become an upper-level holy land. The relations between the three sects began to gradually worsen. Because Carefree Island has the support of the Ten Severing Dao Fruit Tree, our growth is the fastest of the three sects and now we are only a bit away from becoming a true holy land. The other two sects were threatened by us, so they joined forces to suppress us. At the start they merely played their games behind the scenes, but now they have already blatantly revealed their intentions. This is especially true in a competition for resources in the Red Desolate Mystic Realm. Every time rivers of blood flow through the Mystic Realm. Although Carefree Island's Red Desolate Mystic Realm and the Four God Beast Clan's God Beast Mystic Realm were both places that supplied resources, they were extremely different. In the God Beast Mystic Realm, there were extremely few resources, but once these resources were found, their value would inevitably be enormous. There were even some shocking heavenly materials that would move the heart of a world king. Correspondingly, the dangers in this mystic realm were extremely high and it was also suitable as a smelting trial location for disciples. But the Red Desolate Mystic Realm was the complete opposite. There was an immeasurable amount of resources. Here were endless wilds with raw medicinal materials and large swathes of mineral resources. As long as one went in with the intention of gathering materials, they wouldn't even need to look. They could just turn around and gather up a massive amount of resources. However, the value of these resources was relatively low. An extreme talent wouldn't be interested in these resources, but they were actually very important to a sect. Carefree Island had countless disciples and all of them required the support of resources. In a sense, the Red Desolate Mystic Realm was like a mine and the disciples that entered this mystic realm were the miners. As long as the location was a divergent mystic realm, it would be separated from the divine realm by a space barrier. The higher cultivation a martial artist had, the more difficult it was for them to pass through. There weren't many dangers in the Red Desolate Mystic Realm to begin with, so one only needed to send out revolving core level disciples to gather resources and some divine sea realm martial artists to protect against the mystic realm ogres. However, because of the fighting between the three sects, Carefree Island had no choice but to send more and more divine sea disciples. At the start it had been purely about gathering resources, now it had become a proxy war. However, in order to send a divine sea disciple, that required a massive amount of violet sun stones. As it stood, Carefree Island was now stuck in a very difficult position. Carefree Island's reserves of violet sun stones certainly couldn't keep up with the combined reserves of the Occult Bone Clan in Splinter Soul Mountain. Because of this, Carefree Island now held a tremendous disadvantage in Red Desolate Mystic Realm. On the other hand, it was impossible for a true war to break out between the three sects. If there was truly a war in which the sects tried to annihilate each other, the Red Desolate Sea might be swallowed up by some outside influence instead. Weakening Carefree Island's foundation through the Red Desolate Mystic Realm was the most effective way to handle things. As Mo Eversnow understood this, she thought about it for a moment, then said, "So this is what Andy was worried about. I have a proposal. Next time, allow Lin Ming to escort the group in. His cultivation isn't high so it won't cost much to send him through. His combat strength is obscenely high." Mo River Bliss frowned. Lin Ming is only at the 8th stage of life destruction. Although his strength surpasses an early Divine Sea genius, in the Divergent Mystic Realm, when a true battle starts, even a late Divine Sea martial artist could appear. When an all-out slaughter breaks out, even characters like Yi Rosewater and White Mirror Jade will join the fray. Although these resources are important, an extreme talent has no price. If Lin Ming perishes because of this, the loss will be far too great. Mo River Bliss certainly placed importance on the man that Mo Eversnow chose. She had only personally seen Lin Ming's performance in the simulation Mystic Realm. It would be no problem at all for him to become a Holy Lord level character in the future. To send such a genius out into a divergent mystic realm was too risky. But Mo Eversnow smiled and said, "Andy, there is no need for you to worry. There is absolutely no problem. Moreover, to Lin Ming, this is a rare opportunity to temper himself.